In my book Schematics 3, you can find it on the Lulu website, I published quite a few so-called blocking oscillators. They are also called relaxation oscillators, and this is one of the most simple relaxation oscillators that you can make. Ferrite rod or another ferrite core, high voltage winding, backcoupling winding, and here the winding through the transistors. And it's all extremely uncritical. So it always works. That's the good thing from all these simple oscillators. One very important thing is that I've made here two connections, A and B, and when it does not oscillate, reverse the A and the B wiring from the backcoupling coil. So take a ferrite rod, 1000 windings here, 40 windings here from thick wire, 80 windings here from thick wire, and then connect it in this way, and you will surely get a high voltage on the other side from the transformer, with which you can drive a small fluorescent tube. Very easy to make. This circuit, by the way, is a circuit with which you can add for a very short time a higher voltage to that relaxation oscillator. Press the switch. At first two capacitors are charged, say each to 12 volts, and when you press the switch, 24 volt, the double volt, is available. By the way, this is a double switch, this one and that one. They act at the same time. Much more in my book. Want to pan over some other blocking oscillators? All the principles stay the same for these circuits. In fact, it's all very simple, and you'll see that you find in many variations on YouTube on all kinds of electronics channels is in fact also a relaxation oscillator, a blocking oscillator. And here, all these circuits, I've tested them all and they all work. Though, it's important to tell that the transistor here that you use, for instance, when you use one transistor, it has to have a good amplification factor. Minimum 300 or so, or 200. And when you use a Darlington, like it's done here, a Darlington always has an extreme amplification factor. So with a Darlington, you can be sure that your experimental blocking oscillator always works. And when you go to higher currents and higher voltages, use here a power transistor. So for instance, here a BD139, and here also a BD139 NPN power transistor. And here exactly the same circuits. And I tell here that I made, in my book, that I made these circuits with germanium transistors. And the good thing from germanium transistors is that they have a very low barrier voltage. And they are even more easy to make them into oscillation. But here again I've made a Darlington. And you can see here, for instance, that I mounted the backcoupling wiring to get the whole thing into oscillation from here to here via this series capacitor. So this is purely experimental. Could be that in another situation, that depends, that you have to connect this wire here. Do some experiments. Try here or here to connect that wire, and in a certain, on a certain moment, it will surely start to oscillate. when your transistors are healthy. Well, another blocking oscillator with one transistor. The lamp limits the current somewhat. And another blocking oscillator here made with a Darlington. To all these blocking oscillators, the same rules apply. Thin wire, 1000 windings here or more, say 10 up to 50 windings here, 50 up to 80 windings here for the backcoupling coil, and here exactly the same. 80 windings, say a few windings, and thousands of windings to get a good high voltage out. And the diode, of course, in all cases, the diodes must be able to handle that high voltage out, and also the capacitor must be able to handle the high voltage out. All very, very simple circuits to make with good success, and you can even supply, for instance, a small cathode ray tube with it. And the best circuit to supply a cathode ray tube is also in this book, and I have to search for it. One moment, please. I don't hope this video gets too long. One moment. Sorry. This will be too long. Well, sorry for that. Put down the camera for a while. One moment. I have to search that circuit. Well. Oh, no. Oh, yes, here. Here. Sorry that you had to wait. This is the circuit to drive a cathode ray tube. With a kind of blocking oscillator. In fact, it's not a blocking oscillator. The waveform is, I think, a square wave. But anyway, that doesn't matter. And here are the components for a successful circuit.